We from infors welcome you all to this webinar. My name is Lea Düppe and I'm here today with my colleague Kulvan Kandra, and we are both product managers for bioprocess applications. Today we will be answering questions related to the process transfer of mammalian cells from the incubation shaker into the bioreactor. Meet Laura, a junior researcher focusing on protein production and CHO cells, and she has quite a few questions for us on process transfer. So hello, Laura, nice to meet you.
Hi, Lea. It's nice meeting you too.
So how can I help you, Laura?
So I would like to give you some background knowledge of my experiments first. So what I've been doing was that I have successfully screened some CHO cells in the incubation shaker, and I found now the best clone. So the next step is actually for me to take this clone and scale it up to a bioreactor. So I want to be honest to you, however, I'm a bit overwhelmed by the step of process transfer because I've never worked with bioreactors before. And to be honest, I'm afraid that my cells might not survive the shear stress in the bioreactor. So therefore, I would like to ask you, what are the critical factors I need to consider and take care of during process transfer?
Ah, I understand you, Laura. I know that you're a bit skeptic about the success for your cultivation. Yes, and indeed the environment for the cells changes totally since cells are not being shaken anymore in the bioreactor but stirred. However, I think I can help you. Firstly, the mixing within the cell culture broth is an influential parameter that needs to be considered during the transfer. As you can see here in this video, we took it to determine the mixing time of the Miniforce 2 microbial version, where we applied the discoloration method. And as you can see, the media gets clear very fast, so we achieve homogeneous conditions within seconds, because insufficient mixing would result in pH and nutrient gradients, and that has been shown to dramatically influence the cell growth and also the antibody production. Do you understand?
Yes, thanks. Everything clear so far for me.
Perfect. If you're interested in the mixing time of the Miniforce 2 cell, have a look in our application note. You can see here. You can find it for free on our website, and in this application you will see all the results in more detail, like here.
Okay, thanks. I will check that out.
Cool. The second factor that you need to consider is the oxygen transfer rate. During aeration, the gas bubbles come out of the sparger into the media, and then the oxygen molecules are dissolved in the media, as you can see here, and then the molecules can be taken up by the cells. So the so-called OTR, oxygen transfer rate, defines the rate of how fast the oxygen is transferred into the media, and the OUR, the oxygen uptake rate, describes the rate which the cells can take up the oxygen in the media. So therefore, the OTR defines the theoretical maximum cell density, since of course only the oxygen that is dissolved in the media can be taken up by the cells.
Oh yeah, actually that kind of makes sense to me.
Perfect. So yes, I continue, and the OTR is also described by the following formula. So the KLA is the volumetric mass transfer rate, which is multiplied by the difference between the saturation oxygen concentration and the dissolved oxygen concentration. So to ensure an adequate oxygen availability, the agitation speed, gas flow rate, and gas composition need to be controlled in your bioreactor. So I think by considering these factors, Laura, nothing stands between a successful process transfer into the bioreactor.
Oh, thanks. So actually, so far I understand everything, but you just mentioned the KLA. Can you just tell me what is that again?
Ah, yes, of course. The chyle A is known as the volumetric mass transfer coefficient, and it denotes the efficiency of gas transfer from the gas phase into the liquid phase. So the higher the chyle A value, the greater the aeration performance of the cultivation system. It is also an important parameter during the scale-up process, because it is desired, of course, that the cells have the same amount of oxygen available in a larger bioreactor compared to the small bioreactor. And furthermore, the chyle A is process-dependent and can be determined experimentally in every lab. Here, I've prepared a video, and in this video, you can see how the impeller and steering speed influence the bubble size and thereby also the chyle A. So the chyle A increases with increasing stirrer speed, since the bubbles are shred into smaller bubbles, as you can see here. So this enables a better oxygen transfer, and the bubbles are evenly spread inside the bioreactor. Moreover, the chyle A, of course, increases with increasing gas flow, because then, of course, you have more bubbles.
But it looks like, wouldn't that be too harsh for myself, actually?
Ah, I know the stirring in the very video looks actually very harsh, but don't worry, it's a microbial system which has an Russian turbine as impeller, as you can see here. For your cell culture process, of course, you would use a so-called pitch blade impeller, which is much more gentle to the cells.
Okay, good. You're right, that makes sense. But why exactly are smaller bubbles needed then?
So a bigger bubble has a smaller surface compared to the surface of all the small bubbles together, but still have the same volume as you can see in this illustration. So they need the same space inside the bioreactor, but the large bubble has a smaller surface. So by shredding the bubbles, we can increase the ratio from the surface to the volume. And thereby also the chyle A is higher, and as you have seen in the formula, then we also get a better oxygen transfer.
Okay, but I heard that actually bubbles may destroy the sensitive cells, since they do not have any cell wall. So I'm a bit worried. How do I decide which agitation rate to set and not to harm the cells, but still avoid this inhomogeneities in my culture?
Yes, you're absolutely right. This is actually a question we are often asked. And to answer this, we perform tests together with the Zurich University of Applied Sciences. And the results are shown on these two CFD pictures.
One question, I'm sorry to interrupt you, but what is CFD?
CFD stands for computational fluid dynamics, and this is a powerful engineering tool. It can be used to do calculations with which it's possible to simulate flow directions and power input inside the vessel.
And it looks like, are these small arrows in the picture?
Yes, the little arrows show the flow directions you can see here, giving an indication for the quality of mixing. And in addition, the brighter the blue color, the higher the energy input in this area. So as you can see here. So from these simulations, we learned that one impeller causes less stress for the cells, but still provides good mixing, as you can see in the distribution of the little arrows. And moreover, the maximum energy dissipation is lower with only one impeller compared to two, since we see less light blue areas on the left picture. So here you see more bright areas compared to this picture. So does that make sense to you?
Actually, yes. It just looked really, really complex in the beginning. Then it is really.
Ah, yes, that's true. But this study also helped and showed us how important it is to design the impeller optimally. And it was really a great support to evaluate the stirrer configurations for the mini-infors-ht cell.
Okay, but do you have any numbers for the power input you just mentioned in the beginning?
Yes, of course. So all the results are summarized in an application note you can find on our website. So you can see it here. And yeah, there's also the link. So just go to our website, products and minifors, and there you can download it right at the bottom.
Okay, thanks. Now I understand actually the theory, but can you also show me some experimental data?
Yes, the same university, so the Zurich University of Applied Sciences, made a process transfer of CHO cells from a 250 milliliter flask to our minifors 2 version for cell cultures with a total volume of 1.5 liters. This experiment is also described in the application notes I just mentioned before.
Oh, that's nice, actually, because that's exactly what I would like to do. Do you have some more details to show me?
Yes, sure. The process for which they performed was the transfer of the production of IgG, so an antibody that was produced by CHO cells. It was a simple batch cultivation that lasted 8 days. And the goal was to transfer the process from a volume of 80 milliliters in a shaking environment to a working volume of 1 liter in a stirred bioreactor. If you're interested in further settings like pH, oxygen concentration, stirrer speed, and so on, please take a look in the application note.
So thanks, I will definitely do that. But may I ask you, did they get good results?
Yes, of course you can ask, because the results are also shown and published in the application note. So here on this graph, you can see the results for the minifors 2 cell and the shake flask. So the white dots show the IgG concentration and viable cell density of the minifors 2 cell, and the black dots show the results for the shake flask. So as you can see, the viable cell density and IgG production are as good in the minifors 2 cell as in the shake flasks.
But why are the results actually only slightly better for minifors 2 compared to the shake flasks?
Actually, this is even a great result, because by further improving the process in the bioreactor by, for example, adding feed, you will reach way better and higher yields within the bioreactor.
Okay. Yeah, that makes sense. Thank you. This information was very helpful, and now I know actually how I can start to transfer any process into a bioreactor.
Oh, yes, cool. So you're welcome. Yeah, if you need more information, you can also go on the website. There is, for example, the cookbook, which contains basic concepts, recipes, and strategies involving cell cultures as well as microorganisms. And moreover, you will find there a blog with a post that is exactly describing your problem. And of course, there are also other posts that may support you in further bioprocessing. And last but not least, the already mentioned application note. So the process transfer of CHO cell cultivations using the minifors 2 as an example. And this application note contains also information about the process engineering characterization I explained to you at the beginning.
Yeah, great. Thanks, Leah. I will definitely check this out. And don't worry, I believe I will have even more questions, and I will come back to you again, if that is okay.
Yeah, of course. And thanks for getting in touch with us, Laura. I hope I could answer all your questions.
Yes, thanks. Until now, definitely you could.
If you want to keep updated, please follow us on LinkedIn and Facebook to get all the news regarding next webinars, blog posts, or new products. And please feel free to contact us anytime if you need further support. So bye and take care.
Thank you. Take care too. Bye.